We live in a time when the evil people are developing technologies as how far they can do evils. We live in a season where the wickedness of the wicked is growing higher and higher and higher. We live in a dispensation where bad things are happening to good people. We live at a time when you see the children walking with the barefoot and the servants are riding on the horses. We live in a time where people who are meant to carry destiny, the enemy took them from the front line and took them to the back. We live in a time where people who heaven has orchestrated them to build houses, they end up as a tenant. Even that tenant, the landlord is still complaining because they hold debt. We live in a season that you cannot afford not to follow Jesus with all your heart. Come with me to the book of 2 Timothy chapter 3 verse 1. The time and the season we are is a time that believers, you need to be remembered. You need to remind yourself of what we call the Christian principles and doctrine. I'm not talking about church principles. I'm talking about biblical principles. Amazing Grace is a Bible-based church. Everything that the Bible says, that is what we say. Everything that the Bible do, that is what we do. Everything that the Bible believes, that is what we believe. Everything that heaven assigned, that is what we assign. So this is the time, excuse me, you cannot just serve God anyhow. If somebody there, let's read, that will be good.
2 Timothy 3:1.
Yes, ma'am.
This know also
that in the last days, perilous times shall come.
God bless you, ma'am. This is a time the Bible called a perilous time. When you continue reading, the qualification, what will happen at the perilous time is that the love of the people towards God will grow cold. Go to the same chapter, verse 13.
But evil men and seducers shall wax worse and worse.
Thank you. We live in a generation that seducers, terrorists are waxing strong and strong. Can you finish it, please?
Deceiving and being deceived.
Nowadays, the same prophet, they even have more people following them. We live in a generation, excuse me, where good seems to be right. Am I talking to you? And the right that the Bible call right seems to be wrong. I'm going to be speaking plainly to you, reminding you by biblical principle how your Christianity can be better. There are people here, look, God has assigned destiny for you. There are people sitting down now that you are hearing what God is saying to you. You carry a destiny. Am I talking? Can you personalize it? I carry a destiny.
I carry a destiny.
Oh, people like you, but let me hear. I carry a destiny.
I carry a destiny.
I carry a purpose.
I carry a purpose.
I carry a vision.
I carry a
my destiny will not be wasted.
My destiny will not be wasted.
You say it with confidence. Say in the name of Jesus, my destiny will not be wasted. My purpose will not be wasted. My vision will not be wasted. In the name of Jesus, as you declare it, so shall it be in the name of Jesus. Everything that God says about you is so good. Hello? Everything, I'm talking to believers. I'm so privileged to stand in front of great men and women of God. Everything that God says about his word is good. It's great. God don't let us to know that God wish that this goes well with you. That you have peace in your life. But I'm going to be reminding you principles. Biblical principles so that shall can be well with you. I just look at it. There are many. Let's just pick two or two among them. Called the principles of prayer and fasting. Prayer and fasting. Prayer and fasting. 1 Thessalonians 5:17. We are going to read Bible so that you will know that everything I'm saying is right in the word of God. And whosoever among you, as I'm speaking the word of God, said the spirit of determination will be going around.
Amen.
Grace of God will be going around.
Amen.
Empowerment will going around so that your prayer life will be catapulted to the next level in the name of Jesus. 1 Thessalonians 5:17.
Pray without ceasing.
Hello? Prayer is our commandment as a child of God. The Bible says we should do what?
Pray
without ceasing. And it means in the book of Luke chapter 18 verse 1, Jesus said it is good to pray and not to
pray.
Somebody say it is good to pray.
It's good to pray.
We are in the time of prayer and fasting. Let's join fasting together. I'm going to be missing them. But in the important, there are people who are sitting down that you should have reached your desired miracle. It's because you didn't use the weapon of prayer that you have. There are people where you are in a church where the prayer is going on and you turn an attitude of your story. You know, Christianity is character. If you are a Christian, we learn how to be a Christian. We subdue our flesh. Because any Christianity that you are, that does not change your character, cannot help you. How many people are you supposed to be having destiny achieved? But because of their character in prayer. Even during the week, they have no reason not to come. Then they don't come. And they want heaven to favor them. Hello? Hello? We are fasting now. They know they are fasting and they did not fast. And they still want things to work out. I am here to you. Bible says pray without ceasing. When Bible says we should pray, we should pray. That does not say if you did not pray, God will not answer your prayer. But there are some iron-like problem. There are some stubborn pursuers. Jesus says in the book of Matthew 17:21, he said this kind of miracle cannot go not only by prayer. He said you must add what?
Fasting.
Let's go, let's check it out. It's Jesus that said, because fasting is a Christian commandment. Matthew 17:21. Let's read it. God bless you, man.
Matthew 17:21 says, howbeit this kind goeth not out but by prayer and fasting.
God bless you. The verses before was somebody that needed healing. They brought the person to Jesus' disciples. They pray. There was no miracle. Until the parent of the child said, where is Pastor Jesus? If these people cannot do it, the Bible said Jesus healed the man, the boy. And the disciples said, Jesus, what goes on? We have used your name. We have applied the principle. But it doesn't work. Jesus look at them. He said, you, there are some miracles that cannot take place. There are some stubborn man that cannot bow. There are some strong God in the heavenly places. I was speaking yesterday to them in United Kingdom about the ministry of unassisted angels. See, in the second heaven, that is where Satan, Lucifer, Satan is dominion. And he has his secretariat in the water. You remember in the book of Daniel chapter 2, let me just go a little bit back to yesterday ministry back in UK. You know, the Bible says Daniel, he purposed in his heart to fast. And then that is Daniel chapter 10. As he was fasting immediately, this God is so good. God said, angel, my son is fasting. He has determined to fast 21 days. Meanwhile, at the first day, go and give him the blessing. Go and give him the blessing. Give him the favor. The Bible said the angel descended that first day. And that angel was coming by the prince of passion. Oh. The first day he called upon God, his voice was heard. There are people where your voice has been heard. But your problem is you did not know how to pray continuously. If Daniel stopped praying on the second day, guess what will happen? That angel will hold the blessing. Some of you, your angel of blessing is already waiting for more of your prayer. Because your prayer, you assist your angel. Daniel keep on praying that God, I've not seen anything the first week. The second week, I've not seen anything. The third week, that God, you send me your word. That you ask, it shall be given. Immediately, God said, this is my son. Enough is enough. The Bible said, God now sent another archangel. It means that angel needed an assistant for the miracle of Daniel to take place. There are people with the kind of breakthrough that you need. Your angel that is carrying your blessing needed another assistant of the angel of archangel in the heavenly places before that strong man come back. And here you are, we ask you to pray. It's not easy, at least we are in Europe. As if you are the only one in. I am here to challenge your faith. That is time now for you to do what? Look at your life. Who knows that what you need is for your angel to be. be assisted. The ministry of all assisted angels. If God did not send an assistant for that angel that was coming, Daniel should have prayed in vain. I pray may you never pray in vain.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ. So this will say, this kind of miracle cannot come without fasting and prayer. We are in the month of fasting and prayer. We started from 16th of this month to the 29th. If you are a true member of this church and you are not under medication and you know you can fast, I am begging you, fast. But if you cannot fast, pray. But I encourage you to pray. Because prayer and fasting help you to avoid defeat and weakness. The church was born in prayer. If Christians, we need more instruction about prayer. We need to know more about prayer, the value and the purpose of prayer. It is very important. Prayer is the key that unlocks the storehouse of God's grace. All that God is and all that God has is at the disposal of the prayer. Everything that makes God to be God, your money, your blessing, your glory, I don't know what you desire. Everything that God is at the disposal of the prayer. Prayer can do anything that God can do. Prayer is the key. Prayer as a Christian is our priority. Do you want your Christian life to be effective? Do you want to love in every area of your life? As Satan be harassing you and challenging you, do you believe you want to command your miracle? You want to ban your strong man? The Bible is, I command ban a strong man. Without faith, go to his house and tie him. So I'm encouraging you. It is time to go back to the root. Prayer is the key. True prayer, God's will for your life will come to pass. Glory be to God. Because prayer helps us. In the book of James chapter 4 verse 2. Let's quickly read. Because your prayer is great. And your prayer allow your miracles to come to pass. Pray constantly. Pray without ceasing. That will allow all your need to be supplied. God bless you.
James
chapter 4 verse 2.
Ye lust and have not. Ye kill and desire to have and cannot obtain. Ye fight and war, yet ye have not because ye ask not.
Here we are, the Bible let us to know that you did not get because you did not pray. As a Christian, we must know that the purpose of prayer is not to make God to change his will, but to provide him a channel which he may accomplish his will in your life. Your prayer allow God to fulfill his purpose in your life. Your prayer give God a legal grant. Give God a legal permission to do things in your life. And you must also know that prayer is a privilege. What did I say? It's a prayer is a privilege. Do you know that Satan cannot pray? For whom will he pray for? Satan, every Christian who pray. That is why Satan cannot stand, satanic angel cannot stand in arena of a man or a woman of prayer. It is a glorious privilege to pray. The Christian life is full of privileges. Privileges to enter into the holies of holies. Privileges to go to the King of Kings. Do you know the King I'm talking about?
Oh, yes.
To go to the Lord of Lords. Privileges to wake up in the morning and you say, God, this morning I lift up your name. I honor you. Just in your bed, you can enter to the holies of holies. Just in your room, you can go to the palace of the King that won the whole land. And say, God, I lift your name. I honor you. I bless you. It is a privilege. Glory be to God. The book of Hebrews chapter 4, verse 14. Glory be to God. As we are going there, prayer is the Christian fighter bread. Is our oxygen as a Christian. The way we preach as a Christian is prayer. The Christian life is a new life. The life of a risen Lord planted in us through the Holy Spirit. This new life can only be sustained by prayer. It's only by prayer that your faith can be sustained. It's only by prayer you can live a victorious Christian life. Glory be to God. Are you there?
Yes, Hebrews 4:14. Seeing then that we have a great high priest that is passed into the heavens, Jesus, the Son of God, let us hold fast our profession.
Thank you. God bless you. We have the high priest, and Jesus is the high priest. Let even in your bedroom, even in your living room. Yesterday I was telling them we have dimension of prayer. Your prayer, you must have your own personal prayer. And your personal prayer must vomit fire and produce fire. I'm not saying the Christian you are praying, Jesus. You are praying, you are reading Bible, and saliva is already on the Bible. I even advise people, pray 10 minutes effective. It is better for you to say, I also want to pray from 12 to 2. And that 12 to 2, as you are sleeping, you are sleeping. You can choose. The prayer is a spiritual exercise. Don't embark on it after you have walked, you are tired, you are weary. Am I talking? By the time you are tired, you are weary. Already your body cannot take it. Choose to pray at a time that your mind is refreshed. Choose to pray very early. Our mothers, your child wake up by 6, wake up 5:30. Contact God. It is very important because it's our oxygen. That is the way we breathe. It's very, very important. Psalm 55, verse 17. Let me quickly give you 7 reasons to pray. So that as you are sitting down, you will not live your life just by what comes. Dictate for the devil. Hello? Give devil a boundary. Everything that the enemy has stolen in your life, it is only by prayer and fasting that you can take them back. Glory. 7 reasons to pray. Number 1, prayer build our relationship with Jesus. Christianity is not a religion. It is a relationship. Prayer build your relationship. I mean, I will come back to fasting briefly. Prayer build your relationship with God. It connects you to God. It allows you to remind yourself that you are a child of God. It connects you to God. If you have 0 prayer life, may God revive you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I thought I would hear him. I said, if your prayer life is not what it's supposed to be, may God revive you in the name of Jesus. Because your prayer life determines how far you will achieve in life. Hello? The grace has made all things available. But don't forget them, the opening word. We live in the dispensation that the wickedness of the wicked is growing stronger. As a believer, your prayer life must also grow stronger. Because when you pray, your relationship with God is built. Glory be to God. Ephesians 3:14-19. Number 2, when you pray, prayer helps you to overcome temptations. The book of Luke 22:39. Prayer helps us to do what? To overcome the temptations. Temptation of talking wrongly. Temptation of doing things that are contrary. When you wake up in the morning, you commit your deeds to the Lord. Then he said, let the word of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable unto you, O Lord. Because through the thought of your heart, Satan can creep sin. It is very, very important that you diligently wash your heart and that you diligently learn how to overcome temptation. Not only as you are applying principles to overcome temptation, you also pray that God should guide you against temptation. When you pray, it will be done. Another thing, what does the prayer do? Prayer helps us to claim God's will. It is God's will for you to prosper. And the book of Jeremiah 29:10, the Bible says, for I have a plan towards you. Plan of good and not of evil. To give you an expected end. There's things you need to pray. Somebody say, I need to pray. Those of you that we are begging you to come to church, pray. You must have a personal prayer altar, one. You must, family that I am, you must also have a family altar. A family altar is when the father, the mom, and the children. And as a mom, you are living with your children, you are also a family, completed in the eyes of God. Call your children, sit down with your children, announce to your children, children, we want to pray, and do it on a regular basis. Your family altar, it is must also do what? Produce the fire that can nourish the family, that can allow the children that are grown up in the family, know the values of Christianity, know how to connect to God, know how to pray, know how to close the eyes in prayer. It is very, very important. And also, there's another prayer we call a collective prayer or an agreement prayer. The Bible says, one will chase 1,000. And 2 which is, you can pray in your house, that is good. When the Bible says, when 2 or 3, oh God, 2 or 3 gathers together and do what?
Pray.
You know the secret of it. God says, as big as I am, I will be with you. So the faith of everybody connect together. Plus your faith, plus my faith, we can move mountain. All those three levels of prayer, they are same. Every Christian was balanced with it. Don't stand with one leg. Hello? Nothing for me, I pray at home on Wednesday. Come and pray. If you have no genuine reason to sit down at home, come and do what? Come and pray. Even sometimes, at least once, twice in the month, take permission from God that this Friday I want to be in the church. This Wednesday, there are people where you might even be to midweek service. Try and come. Everything prepare you. God's here is to prepare you to be a better Christian. Do you know that your Christianity can be better than this? Am I talking? I don't know your level, but you can be better than this. In understanding, your life can be better than this. Your glory can be better than this. Move to the next level. It is time to move. Prayer help you to claim God's will. Prayer help you to accomplish God's work on earth. God has a work on earth. In the book of India, and our watch world, we say we must walk the walk of Him that sent us. When He was ministry, God spoke to me that in this church, God has started to distribute beauties. Am I talking? I said, God, how? I said, I'm giving beauties. God said, don't you remember in my word, it is written, that how beautiful are the feet, or those who spread good tidings. The day you take it upon yourself to minister Christ to the lost world, the beauty of the Lord will begin to do what? Show forth in your life. Prayer help you to do God's will. A prayer of also is an instrument of spiritual warfare. A prayer is a weapon of a spiritual warfare. Don't forget that one is not a form fear, it's a warfare. Am I talking? The prayer help you to do what? When you are praying, guess what you are doing? Look at me. You are fighting. Am I talking to you? When you are praying, guess what you are doing?
Fighting.
You are fighting. You are wounded. You are killing the strong man. You are saying, Satan in my life, you have no chance. You are saying, Satan in my life, I close the door. I barricade your life. Prayer is a means in which a Christian are engaging in a spiritual warfare. Prayer is also valuable to God. Prayer is very, very important. And now, when you now compare prayer and fasting, in the book of Matthew 17:21, Jesus said, this kind of miracle, this kind of work, this kind of healing, this kind of laughter cannot come except after you have been praying, add what?
Fasting.
I'm encouraging us. Thank God we are in Europe. The being in Europe does not save the biblical principle. Must not be practiced. The biblical principles must be practiced. The biblical principles must be done. So if Jesus said this kind cannot take place, I don't know what you are going through. Hello? I don't know your situation, but Jesus knows your situation. Can I tell you, you have been praying, you don't see answers. Add fasting. What does fasting do? Briefly, number one, fasting humbles you. Fasting does not change God's mind. God is God all the time. His love never change. His will never change. His power, somebody say, never change. You are getting very, very cold. I need you to warm up. His glory can never
change.
His favor can never
change.
His goodness can never
change.
Have you seen God change before?
No.
It cannot change. It's the same yesterday, today, and forever He will be. The lamb upon the throne. But it's over to you. What did I say? What did I say? Over to you. Your Christian life must be a life to that defeat Satan. To defeat Satan is not by bread and mouth. Some of the Christians in Europe especially, they have what we call diabetic Christianity. You know diabetic Christianity. You only take times we come to church when it's convenient. You come when it's convenient. You come when it's not convenient. Holy Spirit ask you to wake up certain time, and your body is saying no. When the Holy Spirit say pray, you pray. You serve God because it's God to be served. What does fasting does? Number one, it humbles you. Number two, fasting makes your prayer to be more fervent. Fasting take away unbelief in you. Fasting put fire on Satan. put fire on the strong man. If the enemy has stolen anything from you, am I talking to you? To the book of Joel chapter 2, 25 say that the years that the locusts and the caterpillars has eaten, that God will restore them. If Satan has stolen all of any of your blessing or favor, then you need to fast. What did I say? Because your fasting puts Satan on fire. Fasting conquer the old man. Fasting, that's when you know the old man. That is the old nature. During the time of fasting, do you know that all of a sudden your face changed? All of a sudden, even I've seen a sister who can joke. She used to joke, but when the fasting is there, I said, sister, you are silent. I said, pastor, it's not easy. Fasting has the will of conquer inner man. Fasting is able to do what? It's able to help you to put off the old man. Fasting pleases the spirit. Fasting put the flesh under the spirit. I encourage during this time of fasting, spend quality time to read the word. Hello? Feed your spirit man with the word. Fasting leave the word of self and take quickly to the realm of the spirit. Fasting train you and me self-control and discipline. Do you know that when you join the army, from the first day when you join the army till the last day, gets what? They will inculcate you discipline. A brother that joined the army, all of a sudden, she has to shave the beard. They will train you up to the greeting, up to the talking. From the first day when you join the army until you are retired, they will tell you the principle. That is how Christian life is. Some of us, our Christian life should have better. You should have enjoyed God better. If truly you learn how to put your flesh under control, and one of the ways to do it is to do what? To fast. Fasting train you to control your appetite. Do you know that when you are fasting, you are hungry as well? When the time to take breakfast comes, your stomach will turn. You say, no, stomach, today we are fasting. Most times, people that thought different type of negative thinking. Do not during the time of fasting, all those things are being subdued. So fasting subdue the loss of the flesh and other evil desire. So I encourage you, people of God, fasting and prayer is our weapon. Use this weapon to conquer the enemy. Use this weapon to have achievement in your life. Use this weapon to put Satan where it belongs. Use this weapon. The Bible says the God of peace will cross Satan under your feet. It is when you are using your weapon. May God give you the grace to use the weapon in the name of Jesus. And we rise up on our feet by the grace of God as well. Truly, thank you for putting your hands together for Jesus. You are clapping for Jesus, not me. Glory be to God. So you are going to pray. And don't forget this particular month, because of the people that have been calling for different prayer. I realize when I'm in the office, you see 20 people sitting down. And at the end, my throat will be so dry. And the Lord said, people that want to see me, it doesn't matter what we do first, is to go to the prayer room. And prayer has been submitted, prepared for you. People that are there, was the prayer room experience? How was the prayer room experience? People that were there and see the hand of God. Brother, you are also there, Lord, son. So I'm encouraging you. Prayer room is already open. Wednesday, it's open between 5 to 6. When you come there, come and pray and see God. And when we were praying on Friday, God said the prayer room has been turned to upper room. God said, because I will be there. To lose shame. And then a sister, she gave a revelation of what she saw after she left the prayer room. I said, God, in fact, that revelation, it humbles me. So I encourage you. You want to come to church on Wednesday? Come early. Go to the prayer room. Start from the deep deliverance. Pray the prayer, and you will see that there is a God that answers prayer. What did I say?
There is a God that answers prayer.
Aha! This is very important. On Friday, as well, apart from when we have the all night, it will not be open. And on Sunday, after we have planned for the convention, today is the last Sunday that we have to plan. For the convention, it is very important that we do that. After we do that, we still go there to do and do what? To go. I'm begging you, pray. What did I say?
Pray.
I saw some, I was praying. She wear clothes, but the cloth was other side. You know, when you sew cloth, there's inner side, there's outside side. She wear the
wrong side.
And that will not be your portion in the
Amen.
God said, look at her. That is a symbol of her destiny. Then I say, God, will you change it? God said, yes, tell her to continue praying. Even the person, God said, don't tell her what you saw, but tell her to keep on coming to the prayer room. So I encourage everybody. Those of us more than you come, you must go to the action. You spend 20 minutes. Don't go to the action. What happens if you don't have supermarket under the church? Will you not come to church? You come to church, go to the prayer room. Pray. What did I say?
Pray.
You want to say, Lord Jesus, stretching my prayer life. Can you say louder and clearer?
Lord Jesus.
Say, Lord Jesus, I need more grace to pray. I need more power to pray. Stretching my prayer life. Pray this for 3 times and pray. Father, in Jesus' name. Father, strengthen my prayer life. 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 In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen, amen, amen. Fire.
The amen is not so, let it go. I want everybody just say amen from the bottom of your heart. Amen is not, to hail the one leading the prayer. Amen means God, let it be. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen, amen, amen. Fire.
Final prayer. Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
Any power anywhere.
Any power
that is mocking my prayer.
That is
mocking at my prayer.
That is mocking
my prayer. This prophecy is coming, you have option. Option one, you can say amen 3 times. And if it belongs to you, you can say amen 7 times. And if you know you want it to be wait and get, go ahead and say amen 721 odd times. Are you ready? Stand for your right hand up. Up, let it be up. You are here to receive. I say you are here to receive. Father, over every hand that I lifted, I decree in the name of Jesus. May God's presence, may God's grace,
amen,
a power,
amen,
an anointing,
amen,
to pray,
amen,
to fast,
amen,
to triumph, life over that and in the name,
amen,
of Jesus.
Amen, 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 amen,
amen, amen, amen, amen, amen, amen, amen. I decree over your life.
Amen.
Any power that has been secretly troubling you. Where is that power? Who has been troubling your Israel? Secretly. They come with a dream that doesn't look as if it's an enemy. But they are enemy. I enter to the anointing of the Lord Jesus. And I speak to every life. The servant has kept in bandit. The servant has fully won't be lost to them.
Amen.
The servant has forced you to. Any authority that has been troubling the Israel of your life,
yes,
the God of Elijah shall trouble them in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Thank you, Lord.
There are people where your mind used to get troubled, but today, Don't say anything. I'm speaking and I'm planting the peace of God. Amen. The peace of God. Yes, you are troubled because of what is going on in the house where you are living. But today God says he's giving you peace.
Amen.
He says he's giving you peace.
Amen.
He says he's giving you peace.
Amen.
He's giving you peace.
Amen.
That you have lost. Because the Bible is the final authority.
Oh, yes.
And the Bible says, for the forever, oh Lord, your word is settled in heaven.
Yes, Lord.
I agree with you as my brother and as my sister. Is there anything that the caterpillar and the cankerworm has eaten in your life that has caused you to shed tears? Whatever the enemy has eaten, possess them back in the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, sweet spirit.
Thank you, Lord.
Blessed be your holy name.
Amen.
We give you praise.
Amen.
We give you praise.
Amen.
We give you praise.
Amen.
You have a court case. God says he's going to take over the case.
Amen.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Lord.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Thank you, Jesus.
You are believing God for the fruit of the womb. See, God says he has visited you.
Amen.